Kyle Lowry found himself in a troubling incident during Wednesday's Game 3, despite his points he was putting up. As he dives into the stands to try to save a loose ball, a fan pushes Lowry as he tries to get up onto the court. The fan was eventually removed from the game. Here's Kyle Lowry describing the incident.
He reached over and put his hands on me for no reason. And then he said a couple, some vulgar words to me repeated them repeatedly. But in our league, there's no place for that. Honestly, I hope he's never allowed to come to an NBA game because he shouldn't have did that. Luckily, they threw him out. I talked to league's security already and explained myself. And, I don't really, the fans have a place. We love our fans, but fans like that, they shouldn't be allowed to be in there because, it's not right. And, I can't do nothing to protect myself. But the league does a good job. And, hopefully they ban him from all NBA games ever.
Jay Will, yep. Richard Jefferson here. You feel strongly about
this. I saw that last night, and I said he should be banned from all NBA games ever. Let me tell you why. Because as a competitive athlete, when you're lost in that moment, and I understand you're supposed to be bigger than the game and always uphold yourself to a higher standard, but when I'm lost in this fire of battle like I am every day with RJ, if somebody randomly comes out and just pushes me in the middle of the game, what if my reaction is to swing back real quick or to push you back? It turns into an altercation. It turns into a potential Detroit Pistons situation,
right.
And that's how things escalate. So, yes, he should be banned from all NBA games.
1,000%. There were guys, and again, we're not going to compare this to the malice in the palace,
yeah.
But there were guys that were having criminal charges brought up against them, and that's not the situation. But the point is that man's push could have affected the outcome of the NBA finals. Like you said, if Kyle Lowry would have pushed the guy back or done something, and then somebody throws a drink at Kyle and somebody loses, or his fan or his teammates rush over to help out, all of a sudden, if you have suspensions during the NBA finals because a fan that was sitting in the front row decides to just push a player for no reason, that's why the person has to be gone forever.
It's one thing to have home court advantage or maybe a hostile environment at your home court. These things are obviously not acceptable, but do you ever feel like fans do sit too close to the court? Some of these courtside seats, it's prime real estate to try to be there.
No, I love the jarring. I love the back and forth. I think same way with Drake. I love stuff like that, but there have to be boundaries, and you have to understand, okay, you are part of the game, but you're not in the game.
And that's what makes our sport so great. There's not many sports in the world where the fans are literally in the sport.
Yes. Right.
Not football, not baseball. You are in the sport, and that's what makes it great. So we don't want to lose that. That's what helps the visibility of players. That's what helps the marketing of players. We don't want to lose that, but there needs to be some very, very strict guidelines. And the people that are sitting courtside paying that amount of money for the games are very, very typically powerful people or very, very wealthy people. And so it's not always easy to do it, but he needs to be gone.
I think one of the guidelines should be, and those are very powerful people, but if you're sitting in the front row, and I'm not saying that there's alcohol involved here, but there should be some kind of limitation if you're in that first row, what kind of alcohol consumption you can have. Because
that's
people sometimes can get overboard with stuff like that, and that's when you can lose control.